Thank you. Susan, and this is the Foster Farmhouse, and thanks for joining me today. I'm going to be doing a little bit of seed starts today. I'm going to start, I'm going to do a flat of these onion bulbs, yellow sweet Spanish Utah seeds, and it says to start them now, and I'm going to be planting them probably around May 4th, so it'll take a while for these to sprout and grow. So I'm going to plant a whole flat of these because I want a lot of these onions. I love onions. And I'm going to do some in this little carton. I took a milk carton and I cut it around and just stopped right at the handle. And I'm going to put some potting soil in there. But before I do, I have to mix water into it. And kind of get it a consistency where it will be like where you can grab it together, but it's not dripping of water. And so I want to kind of get this soil moist. And so I'm going to pour some water in this potting soil. And I'm going to put it into that milk carton. And I'm going to do a winter sowing. I've never done it before. It's my first time. And I'm just going to put it in there and plant some Iceland poppies. My daughter, who's also a gardener, both my daughters are, but one of my daughters, Samantha, she told me that her Iceland poppies did really good. Need some more water. It did really good in the winter seed starting outside. So you put it in a milk carton and you put some potting soil in it. Not seed starting mix, but potting soil. And you get it wet, so see how that's kind of clumped together? I don't know if you can see that. But it's not dripping, so I think it's okay to put it in there right now. And I just gonna just start filling up this milk carton with the potting mix. I'm gonna plant the Iceland poppies in here and see if they can handle cold. So I think this will be great out here. I outside and see how they do through the rest of this winter and how it will end up. So I'm just gonna move that out of the way. So I filled it up with my soil and I'm gonna take my Iceland poppies, which I got from Floret, and it's a sherbet mix. So that'll be really pretty. And I'm just gonna sprinkle these seeds, very, very tiny. I doubt that I need to even, I'll just press them down so they can make contact. Whoops, oh that was, so they're just so tiny, I can't even see them. So I'm just gonna sprinkle them around. There's some water there. I think I'm gonna take these gloves off. Makes it harder to see. Yeah, so. I'm just gonna sprinkle that around. Don't wanna waste one seed. There's a couple seeds in there, I think. And I'm just gonna kinda press it in. And I poked holes on the bottom of this. And I also, I wrote a little tab on there. So I'm gonna slip it in there so I know what it is in there. I won't forget. And I'm also gonna put it on the lid, Iceland poppies. And I have this water that I think is really cool. You can just take an old pop bottle and you buy these lids that have little holes in it and you just screw it on. You can get it on Amazon and it waters it gently. It's just a really nice, gentle, and I'm just gonna water that in. Really good. And then you're supposed to cover it up. And then I'm supposed to tape it with duct tape. And I leave the hole. So I'll tape it up with duct tape and I leave that the hole on the top uncovered, and it's supposed to get a good amount of water in there and moisture, and it'll be like your own little terrarium to keep it from getting frost on it, and just keep it safe. And just stick it outside in a sunny location and just check on it and make sure it doesn't need to be watered. It shouldn't, but it might get dry depending on your weather. But if it's moist, you just don't have to really do much to it. Just stick it out in a sunny location. But then you put duct tape all around here. And so I'm gonna go do that next. So now I'm gonna get some duct tape. I'm going to go ahead and tape this all up. So there I have my Iceland poppies. But by June, I'll be able to plant those out in the yard, I hope. Anyways, so we'll see how that goes. And now I'm going to be doing another project. I'm going to be sowing some onion seeds and some foxgloves. So I'm going to do one of these for onions and the other one for some foxgloves that I want to plant in the yard. So I'm going to sow those today. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my bowl again, and this time I'm going to use it's seedling mix, and it's by Black Gold. I usually like to use organic, but I couldn't find any organic. I went to a local store nearby and I couldn't find any. But I want to fill my bowl up with my seedling mix. And I want to take some water. I'm going to fill that up. And I just want to pour that in there. And I'm just going to mix it all around. I'm just going to get my hands dirty. Just one. This way I can kind of feel it. I just want to mix that all in there. It's going to need more water. I'm going to pour it in here. I'm going to pour a lot more. I think it just needs a lot more. It's absorbing the water pretty good. Okay, I think that's how I do it. I just want to, like I said, I want it to come together, but I don't want to be able to squeeze water out of it. So, but I want to thoroughly mix it in here. So, kind of reminds me of mixing a cookie dough with my hands. I don't normally do that, but I do that with bread sometimes. So There's no water coming up, but it's holding together, so I think that that's good. And I'm just gonna put this on my trays and just fill them up like that. So that's what I did today, is I just did some seed starts of my yellow Spanish onions, and I also did some Brandywine tomatoes today. So I did some tomatoes, and I did some Brandywine tomatoes, and there's some more sweet Utah onions, and I was going to do my foxgloves, but I think I will just wait because I decided to start my tomatoes, and I will start the flowers. I'm going to do foxgloves, and I'm going to do a bunch of other flowers, and I'll show you that next. So for my seed haul, I was just going to show you really quick. I'm going to be planting some California poppies from Floret, and I'm going to be planting some zinnias, which is a beautiful Benares giant vine, which will sound, that just sounds beautiful, and some larkspur. And what you have to do with larkspur is you have to put it in your freezer for about a week before you plant it. And then I'm gonna just sow it right out into the soil. I am going to do some seeds with phlox. I'm gonna start some seeds indoors. And I bought some amaranth, and it's a beautiful coral fountain by Floret. And I'm gonna start some seeds from that. And some sweet peas, which are, they're a beautiful sweetheart mix. So I'm excited about that. And a blue shift sweet pea. So I'm gonna start those in February 23rd, because you're supposed to do it 4 to 6 weeks before your last frost. So I will be doing that soon. And these are the tomatoes that I planted today, and I also planted my onion bulbs, which are the sweet onions, yellow sweet Spanish Utah onions that are supposed to get really big. So I'm excited about that, and I will be planting my foxgloves here really soon. So I'll have some flowers to plant that I'm going to be starting from seeds inside, and some vegetables as well. And I will show you that another time. So this is my little greenhouse for now, until I buy a nicer one for now. But this was just only like $45 on Amazon, and it had a cover that I thought would keep things nice and warm in there. I've got a grow light that I bought, and I've got my tomatoes and my onions in there, and I'm going to be putting another grow light down here, and I'm going to be putting flowers that I want to grow in the garden down there. And so, yeah, I think this will do for now. It's down in my basement, and once those seedlings come up, I'm going to take the plastic off and make sure that, or at least lift it up a little bit, and I'm going to put a fan on very low so that it can kind of get a breeze through there and help keep the little seedlings strong. If you have a little bit of a breeze, it just helps it be strong and ready to go outside. So anyways, yeah, and here's the box. I got it on Amazon, and I'll show you. There it is. So it's a four-tier grow house, and it wasn't too bad to assemble, pretty easy, and I'm gonna see how that goes. I didn't want to spend tons of money right now for lights and everything. I have another light that I got. It's one of these. I'll show you. I packed it away in here. I'm in my storage room, but oops, can I get it out? It is one of these shop lights. It's a 5,000 lumen, 250 watt, 45 actual watts used, 5,000 lumens, a shop light. And I'm just going to hang that on one of the shelves in here and just put some plants in there. So get some flower starts and a little bit more vegetable starts in there. And also on this shelf here. So I'll probably hang that light up a little higher and figure out how I'll do that so I can use this shelf here too, and I'll just hang that up higher. So anyways, I'm gonna get a couple more smaller little lights and hang them in there. So that's what I'm gonna do. I hope it turns out. So I'm gonna be placing, I think that's gonna get a lot of sun. So I'm gonna just be placing my Iceland poppies right here. Actually, maybe I'm gonna put it, I don't think it'll blow away and it gets the most sun. I think what I'll do is I'm just gonna set it right there in the garden and see how it does. It's in one of my flower or vegetable beds, raised beds, but take a look at this garden. I didn't, it's snow everywhere. Here's my new area, my market garden that's all rose. And then here's raised beds in here that you can't see, they're covered with snow. My raspberries over there. And there's my Iceland poppies. I might try to do some more winter sowing and try some other things and stick it out here and see how it does. And compare it to my seed starts that are in the house. So, anyways, thanks. There's Tim fixing his tractor with his fireman. This is his little golf, virtual golf thing. This is his shop.
Yeah, there is probably a return line. That one felt like there's a little more pressure.